Hello friends, welcome to our channel Physics for You. And yes, in this particular video, under the heading or under the practical series, we will study today the experiment to find Young's modulus using Koenig's method. So you might have seen different methods to find the Young's modulus in your 12th standard or in first year, second year. So this is what another method just to find the Young's modulus. So obviously it is developed by the scientist Koenig, and that's why its name is Young's modulus or Y by Koenig's method. So yes, the aim of this experiment is to determine the Young's modulus of given particular material or of a given what we can say a beam of wooden material using Koenig method. So here we required some apparatus that we have mentioned on the chart. So don't worry, this chart you will get in the description box, or the link of the PDF format of the chart will be given in the description box of this video. So you from there you can take the detailed chart. And this is what the formula that we have to use. And yes, you can see some observations are there, or whatever may be the terms involved in the formula, 3 W L square alpha D B D and X, all the terms we have shown in the or below the exact formula. So let me first of all explain you the method or the methodology by which we have to do this experiment. So what we will do here, we have a wooden beam, okay, a wooden beam is like this, and in which at the center we have an hanger to attach the mass, okay. And what we have to perform or what we have to do is, of this beam, of this wooden scale, we have to find the Young's modulus, okay. So first of all we will keep these two this beam on two knife edges exactly like this, okay. So we will fix those knife edges to the table or some other stand, and of which we will keep this beam like this on the knife edges, right. Now whatever may be the arrangement on this beam, you will find we have two mirrors, movable mirrors. So one of the mirror I will keep here and another mirror I will keep here. So not on exactly the knife edges, they are little bit away from the knife edges. So these are what, two mirrors which are mounted on the beam. So those are the removable and movable also, we can move here and there those two mirrors, okay, right. And again we will arrange one vertical scale here, a vertical scale exactly which is very very close to the this end of this our beam, okay. This is a vertical scale, our normal scale, meter scale we can say, okay, of which we have different readings from 1 centimeter to 100 centimeter, yes, 1 centimeter to 100 centimeter, we know this is what the scale, right. Now and to this side we will keep a table, a stool like structure, and on which we will mount a telescope. We'll mount a telescope, okay. So this is what, a telescope, right. Now don't worry, I will explain why these arrangements are okay. And yes, so we'll adjust. Now first of all we have to take the reading of zero mass also, okay. So therefore what we'll do, instead of attaching weight, we will take the first reading. So here how much mass is attached? 0 gram, that means no mass. Now how to adjust these mirrors? These mirrors are movable as well as we can tilt them as per our requirement. So we have to focus. Now you are looking from this point, this is what our eye, we are looking from this point, okay. So you have to look from this point, and we have to focus this telescope, we have to focus this telescope on this mirror, on this mirror, okay, such that now the reflection of this scale will be found in this mirror, Okay, so this is what the image of the scale we will find here. We have to adjust this mirror like this, you will get the image of this here, and the image of this scale which is already in the mirror, we will get here its image in this particular scale, in this particular mirror, and here we are focusing that on this. So that means the image of this scale, first of all, we will get in this mirror, and its a reflection you will get here. Since it is a mirror image, here we will find the inversion, and inversion of inversion means original image. So from the telescope you can find the real image. Try to understand. Okay, now you can see the original scale, because double reflection takes place and original beam will be or original scale will appear in the telescope in which you are looking. Okay, right. Now this telescope will have a horizontal cross wire, right? If I am looking from the view of telescope, you will find the horizontal cross wire, and we are finding the image of this scale, right? Real image. And so this cross wire is exactly coinciding with one of the reading of this particular scale. Let us consider it is 30 centimeter. So that reading you have to note time every time. Remember, horizontal cross wire of telescope will coincide with one of the reading or one of the line on this particular scale, and that reading you have to note down. So for 0 gram you will note down whatever, maybe let us consider 30 centimeter. And in this order you have to move, and to this we will attach one of the hanger, then in the order of 50 gram. So 50 gram we will attach, again the different will be the reading or this cross wire will coincide with different what we can say line on the scale, note down that. Then attach again 100 gram, and in this order we will attach up to 300 gram or 250 gram. Okay, right. So once you got this reading, what happens? Once you attach the mass, this beam is bending. This beam starts bending, and due to this bending, what happens? These mirrors also have some deflection in downward direction, and due to the deflection in mirror, what happens? The scale, even though the scale is steady, the mirrors will have deflection along with the beam, because whatever may be those two mirrors we have fixed on the beam only. So since beam is depressed, that means mirrors also depressed, and there will be variation in the image which is shown by the double reflection of these two mirrors, and that's why you will have the change in scale reading. So this is what we call the depression. And whenever we want to find the Young's modulus, we want either the change in length or some depression. So this is what we are loading, it is at the center, so the depression will be there, and obviously we will find that depression, and by using that we will find the further Young's modulus. So this is what actually method, or sorry, we can say this is how we have to take the readings only. Now what next we have to do? I am talking about this observation table, right? So how is the observation table? Like this, load in gram. So that's what I said, initially 0, then 50, then 100, 150, 200, 250 and 300. Okay, we'll see. Then load increasing again, as we know, we will take for our accuracy purpose, we will take either two trials, or we can take here while increasing one of the reading and while decreasing the load on another reading. So first of all, we will increase the load and we will write down the readings in this order, and while decreasing the load we will write down in reverse manner. Okay, then we are obviously corresponding to one of the weight, we will take the sum, or sorry, the mean of those two readings, those two scale readings, and that will be the mean column. And depression, now see, if I am talking about the first reading is 30 centimeter and second reading is 28 centimeter, okay, the mean reading 28 centimeter. Now how to find the depression? Means by how much centimeter the beam has been depressed. So 30 minus 28 centimeter, that means for corresponding to the first weight 50 gram, the beam has been depressed by 2 centimeter. Yes or no? So this is how to find the depression. Last column, you have to subtract all the readings from the first reading, corresponding first reading, right? Every reading you have to subtract from the first reading to get the depression corresponding to that particular weight. Okay, now once you got this depression, we call it as x, we call the depression as x, and here is the mass m. So let us draw the graph between these two columns, mass and the depression x. So how to draw the graph? Yes, you will see here. So to draw the graph, we have to take the mass on x axis, or we can take on y axis, and x on x axis, right? Now if we take the if we plot the graph, we will find a straight line curve which is going through the origin, and whatever may be the slope of this graph will be x by m. Slope of this graph will be x by m, right? And now see what we want in the formula. Let us see the formula once again. So in the formula, see here, this w, I can convert this formula like this. See, now I will write this formula as, see, this w is nothing but what? Mg. We know that w is nothing but mg, mass into acceleration due to gravity. So among that mass, g I will write here first of all. So 3g l square alpha plus 2d. I will explain what is alpha, what is d and all, don't worry. And 2b d cube. Now what remains? I will write in multiplication from the numerator. What remains is m. We don't have written g, we have written here, but m. So m, and from the denominator I have not written x, so x I will write here. So m by x, right? Now come to the graph. So what is the formula here? 3 g l square alpha plus 2d, 2 b d cube, and here it is m by x, but the slope is x by m. So therefore the slope we have to keep in denominator. And once you put the slope here and all the things, now what are all the things? So L, we will see what are the different observations. L is nothing but distance between knife edges. So this is a scale on which also we have the different readings. So simply take the gap, this between, or the distance between two knife edges, this is your L, small L. Right. What is next? D is the distance between scale and the more remote mirror. Scale means this vertical scale, and more remote mirror means which is away from this scale. So this distance is capital D. This distance is capital D. Alpha, distance between mirrors. So whatever may be the distance between two mirrors, that is alpha. Okay. Right. Now next is breadth, means the breadth of this particular beam we are finding, for which we are finding the Young's modulus. And obviously depth means thickness of this mirror, thickness of this particular beam or scale. Thickness, x change in scale, that is difference, and depression, and y is our Young's modulus. So this is how all you have to make all the observations first of all, then take the readings in accordance with our observation table. Fill the observation table, get the depression, draw the graph versus depression versus mass, take the slope, that will be the x by m, and keep the slope in the denominator by adjusting the formula. And if you keep all the things, so breadth and depth, breadth you have to find by using vernier caliper, and depth, that is thickness, you have to find by screw gauge, right? So by doing all these things and substituting in y formula, you will get the Young's modulus of that scale, this scale, Young's modulus of this scale by our Koenig's method. And obviously we are doing it in CGS unit, so unit will be dyne per centimeter square, or if you are to convert it into the MKS, it will be Newton per meter square, right? So yes friends, now let us move towards the experimental part. Now friends, come to the experimental part of our Koenig's method to determine the Young's modulus. As you can see, a beam is fixed on two knife edges. Now this is the first knife edge, second knife edge. So these two knife edges I have attached to this particular table, you can say, and on which we have mounted this beam. I can show you by having some, yes, and at the center we have one particular hanger to which we can attach the weight or mass. And now these two mirrors, as I told, so these two mirrors are fixed on this particular beam. Now this is what the beam, or this is what the scale of which we want to find the Young's modulus, right? Now this these mirrors are movable, so to by adjusting these mirrors, what we have to do, first of all we have to see the reflection of this vertical scale in this mirror. So I can just see this image and image of this scale, and yes, these what that's what I said, these are the movable mirrors. So let us adjust the mirror such that I can see, or such that you will find the image of this vertical scale in this mirror. Okay, right. Now I can see the mirror image of this scale, but obviously the numbers are, I can see, inverted, right? This is obvious. Now let's second thing, now look into this mirror, second mirror, and try to find or try to focus this mirror or try to get the image of that scale which is already here in this particular mirror. In this mirror means double reflection, once in this mirror and then its reflection in this mirror. So that is what we have to see, and now by just adjusting I can see, yes, the image of that image of image we will find here, or we can say reflection of reflection, that means original image. Now here I can see the original image of this scale. Now I am not talking about this original scale, but in the mirror. So in the mirror I can see the original scale by having double reflection, and this telescope we have to focus on this mirror. Okay, let us ensure once this whether it is focused well or not. Yeah, now through this telescope I can exactly see the scale, and obviously through this second mirror, not the direct scale, right? Got the idea? Now when you are looking through the telescope, or as I have just seen, I can see the vertical vertical crosswire and horizontal crosswire of the telescope, eyepiece of the telescope, but the horizontal crosswire is coinciding to some reading of this scale in the mirror, and that is what the reading, first reading, and how much mass we have attached, 0 gram, that is what the first reading. Okay, now for the second time what I will do, this hanger is itself of 50 gram, so let us attach to it. Now we have attached. Now let us go to the telescope and see that horizontal cross wire is coinciding on what reading of this scale in this particular mirror. Now onwards you need not to disturb anything, you just have to attach the mass and go to the telescope and look at the coinciding reading of horizontal wire. Okay, obviously it is, if the first reading was 30, then yes, it is less than 30. Then we have different masses, again this 50 gram we have attached already, 50, and this 50, now 100 gram. Go to the telescope, look into the eyepiece and see the coinciding reading of horizontal cross wire. This is how we have to go for the, now this is 100, then 150, then 200, and then 250. 5 readings are sufficient. Now once you attach all the masses or all the weights that we have, so what, how much we got? It is 250 gram. Okay, and if you see, now you will find there is a maximum depression of the beam. Now beam has been depressed with the maximum depression, and that will be the noted reading. You can get the reading, right? Now this is what, while increasing load. So for accuracy purpose, what we are doing, we are taking the readings while decreasing load also. So I will just remove one of the mass. Now how much it remains? 200. From 250 I have taken out 50 gram, that means 200. So again take the reading of 200 and write it in the decreasing column in reverse manner, bottom to top. So now slowly you have to decrease 50 gram mass, and again we will take the corresponding readings and we will write those readings in a particular manner, and we will take the average of those two reading, and that will be the mean depression. And now that reading, or mean scale reading, and that scale reading you have to subtract it from the very first reading to get the depression. Once you got all the values, then just keep this aside. Next, what we have to measure? The observations. What is that? the L is the distance between knife edges. So don't worry friends, this itself is a scale on which we have the ruling things. So this knife edge, it is at, now let me see, this is at 80 and here it is at 20. That means 80 minus 20, how much is the distance between two knife edges? 60 centimeter. Similarly, we have to get the D. Capital D is nothing but what? Capital D is the distance of this scale and more remote mirror. More remote mirror. So here, from this point to this mirror itself, so it is 76 centimeter, right? Then alpha. Alpha is the distance between two mirrors. So alpha is just here, one is the 76 and other is 26, so obviously 50 centimeter. So all the observations we got, but yes, some remains, and that are what now we got. We have to get the breadth and depth. So to find the breadth, we are using vernier caliper. We know that this is vernier caliper. Just attach it to one of the position, take the main scale reading, vernier scale reading. Likewise, we will take at three different positions to get the accurate value, and then we will get the breadth. Similarly, to find the depth, we will use the screw gauge. This is screw gauge. Again, we have a main scale and a circular scale. Its least count is 0.001, and let us attach it to the beam of which we want to find the thickness. Yes, I will take at this point one of the reading, take the main scale reading, circular scale reading. Similarly, at some other point, say, see, there is irregularity in this depth. That's why we are taking the reading at three different points, and so that you will get the accurate reading or accurate depth of that particular beam. So all the observations we have done, and then finally we have to substitute all these values. So yes, once you got the depression, then we have to draw the graph between depression and the mass, and its slope we have to get. And once all these things we are ready with, then you have to submit the values or substitute the values in formula y is equal to. So substitute all the values and let us take the answer. Let us see that in our calculation part. Okay, so let's go towards the calculation part. This is all about experimental setup. Yes friends, now come to the calculation part here. First of all, we'll see the observation table, how we have filled it. So as I told you, for the first, by without attaching any mass, that means with the 0 gram, we will take the first reading. So as you can see, for the 0 gram, I found that the when we are increasing load, we got 36 reading, and when we were decreasing, again we got the 36 reading. Mean of that will be 36. And how to get the depression at this mass? Is there any depression? No. That means 36 minus 36, it will be 0. Now attach the 50 gram. So I found that there is a lowering of reading, and it is 35.2. And when we were decreasing the load, again we got the similar reading, 35.2. Mean of this will be 35.2. And now to find the depression, let us subtract 35.2 from 36, and it will be 0.8. That means due to this 50 gram weight, the beam has been depressed. Beam has been depressed by how much centimeter? 0.8 centimeter. Similarly, for 100 gram, we found this is the depression, and if we subtract this depression from 36, again we got 1.8 is the depression. Similarly, we'll do up to 300 gram. So maximum depression will be obviously for maximum weight. So the maximum weight is 300 gram. So for 300 gram, we found the mean scale reading is 31. And if you subtract this 31 from 36, very first reading will got 5 centimeter. So due to 300 gram weight, the beam has been depressed by 5 centimeter. This is what the meaning. Okay, right. So once you got this, next we have to plot the graph between these two columns, load and the depression. So that is what we have done here, right? I hope you see, you can see the graph, right? Okay. So here we have taken mass along this axis, and x, that is depression. Don't get confused, depression. X means not x axis, x is here, we denote it as depression. Okay. Now you can see, we found here is one of the point, here is another, then third, fourth, fifth and sixth. So this is what exactly a linear graph which is passing through the origin. And yes, here we have taken the slope. So once you just decided where to take the slope, now this is a straight line, you will find the similar slope whatever point you are taking. So once you got this slope, so how to find the slope? Y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1, and this is what the slope. So this slope is nothing but what? Y-axis coordinate or y-axis component divided by x-axis component. On the y-axis we have taken x depression, and on the x-axis we have taken mass. So the slope is x divided by m, and it is nothing but we here found 0.016. You yourself please do the calculation, not necessarily you also get this same value, right? Now once you got the half portion is done, now let us see other calculations or other observations. To for other observations, we know the depth of the bar. So we are using screw gauge. The least count of the screw gauge will be 0.001 centimeter, and obviously to get the accurate value we will take the three trials at three different positions, and we found there is a little bit change in the circular scale reading, and the average value of the depth we found it is 0.607 centimeter. Similarly, to find the breadth of the bar, we will use the vernier caliper whose least count is 0.01 centimeter. Again, we will take the three different readings at three different points. Main scale reading is again same. There is a slight difference between the vernier scale reading of these two readings, and the average value of the breadth of that bar is found to be 3.04 centimeter. Now these values are okay. Now let us talk about the other values we are taking, and yes, these values are here L, alpha and D. L, we know that the distance between knife edges, it is found just 77 centimeter. D, the distance of vertical scale and the more or the far away mirror, or more rear mirror we can say, it is 76 centimeter, and alpha is the distance between those two movable mirrors, it is 48 centimeter. Now see, all values we found, and just we have rearranged this, and this is nothing but the reciprocal of our slope. So substitute all the values, and after substitution of all the values and by doing the calculations, it is found that the Young's modulus of given bar, which is of wood material, is found to be, it is centimeter square, it is found to be 1.623 into 10 raised to power 11 dyne per centimeter square. So this is up to this point you have to reach. You should got answer similar like this, not necessarily exactly the same. And yes, finally we will write the result as the Young's modulus of the material of the given bar is found to be 1.623 into 10 raised to 11 dyne per centimeter square, right? Yes friends, this is all about the Young's modulus by using Koenig's method. I hope you got the points. I hope you got the idea how to perform this experiment. And yes, if you have any doubt, you can post in the comment box. And if you feel this is value addition to your knowledge, then like our video, subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon so that you will get the notifications of our next video. And yes, don't forget to share with your friends, right? So yes, thank you friends for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video with new concept, new experiment. Till then, keep watching, keep learning, and take care. Thank you. Thank you so much.